What's going on, everyone? Today is Thursday, May 26th. Oh, Jesus. May 26th, 2016. The baby just fell. And this is the first vlog I'm making this week because Rebecca and I have had the stomach bug. And Brody, because, I mean, he threw up, like, twice this week, but not like we had. I think his shots that he gets keeps him from getting that. But I'm not 100% sure. Long story short, Rebecca went to work Tuesday. And I called her and said, Brody threw up yesterday, and he threw up today again, Tuesday morning. Then she makes a doctor's appointment. She comes home, and she turns out she's not feeling too well, and she has a stomach bug. So we skip his doctor appointment. He seemed like he was doing okay because she couldn't go anywhere. And I wasn't going to, you know, do that without her. But I knew I was going to get it. I took care of her Tuesday. Then Wednesday morning, I wake up throwing up. Everywhere, like, well, not everywhere. I went to the toilet. Basically, Wednesday I spent the stop it. Basically, the entire Wednesday I spent it in front of and on the toilet and in bed, and that's what Rebecca did Tuesday. But it's now Thursday. I feel a little better. I'm not 100%. I'm actually kind of bummed I didn't video log me throwing up, but I had no tripod. It was brutal. I mean, it was like it was like eight big yaks. But he keeps throwing up. I woke up today, and he threw up again. So I don't know. We got to get him to a doctor. But as long as he doesn't have a fever, the doctor says nothing to worry about. He might just get rid of it on his own. But yeah, I woke up today not feeling too well, and I had to wash all his stuff again because I only had that one plastic mat that goes under it. But all right, let's start our day. I'm going to go out here, and I'm going to clean these gutters. So I figured I'd put him over here against the window so he can watch. You going to watch Dad clean the gutters? Huh? You want Dad clean the gutters? We already saw Frank out there. He said he'll take you for a walk later when it cools down. Because there's no way you're going outside. It is 92 degrees out. We can't have a baby out in 92 degree weather. But we got your fan going, man. Feels good in here. We got you in just your diaper. You feel good. Well, Daddy's going to go out there and do them gutters. I don't know if you guys can see from up here. I'll zoom in. You'll see when I go out there. But they are really, really clogged. Yeah. So I need to get out there and do these. I might do more yard work. We'll see. See how mommy feels when she gets back. Because I gotta leave her with you. And yeah, another funny thing I wanted to say was, look, he's never been over the windowsill, so he put his bottle over here. I walked in and he was trying to pull his bottle through. Because I guess he couldn't figure that out. Brody, get your bottle, look. Don't you wanna get your bottle? Here. But yeah, he was pulling out. It was really funny. Here, buddy. Drink up. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go start these gutters. Let's go.
Look, it's Kitty Boo Boo. Kitty Boo Boo. Boo Boo. Kitty Boo Boo. Boo Boo, you gonna watch Brody while I go out there? Kitty Boo Boo.
She's not talking to us.
Boo Boo. Boo Boo. Boo Boo.
This is a cat that never shuts up in the middle of the night, whining and crying to us for attention.
Boo-boo! Boo-boo!
Here, boo-boo. You go hang out with Brody. Whoosh. You play with Brody in the crib.
Get that kitty boo-boo, Brody. Get the boo-boo. Yes, the boo-boo.
She's here to protect you in case somehow you figure out how to crawl out here, but I doubt you will. This is pretty sturdy. That's my fear. This will probably be an only one-time thing. Watch out for her brown eye, buddy. Ew, stay away from that thing. I don't think she liked that very much. You don't want to go near her butt. That's gross.
Kitty boo boo! Boo boo! Boo boo! Boo boo! Yeah. Captain Creature. Creechy! Creechy! Creechy want to go in the bed with the baby? Creechy don't care about going in the bed with the baby either. Look, it's Creechy's in the bed with the baby.
Take it easy, buddy. You gotta be gentle with the Creechy. He's an old man. He's an old man. You gotta be gentle with him, though. Oh, boy. Watch out. He might bite you, buddy. Even though I don't think it's okay, buddy. He's not gonna hurt you. Creechy. I don't think he would bite. I don't think he would bite. Be gentle. He's got a pet. You don't smack into him, though. Creature, be nice. I don't think he understands very much. Come on, buddy. Why don't you just jump out? You don't want the baby on. You don't. Okay. You're getting a little too rough, buddy. Come on, Creechy. Come on. Come on, Creechy. Jesus Christ. Don't hurt Creature. Hey, no, 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 no hitting. No, you don't. I know you're trying to just pet. You pet. Come on, buddy. Come on, Creechy. Creature, come on. Jesus. Come on, Creechy. Creechy. Brody's not letting go of Creature. Creature just woke up from a nap, so you can tell he's like a little out of it. Boosh. Run, Creature, run. Now's your chance, Creature. Get down. Get out, Creature. Creature, go. You gotta be nice to Creature. Creature, what are you waiting for? I think he likes this. In a way, he thinks it's playing time. Be nice to Creature. You don't want Creature to bite you. He's got no front claws, but he might bite you. He's never bitten anybody, but you never know. Oh, Jesus. I mean, he's going to do this eventually anyway when we're not around. Come on, Creature. Creature, run. Come on, Creature, run. Run, Creature, run. Run, Creature. Why are you taking so long to run from this baby? What are you doing? Come on, Creature, jump out, Creature. Be free. Get away from him. Oh, Jesus. Brody, don't pull. I know he doesn't understand. Oh, my goodness. He just loves you, Creechy, that's all. He doesn't mean to hurt you. Oh, Jesus. Come on, buddy. You gotta be careful how hard you hit. Come on, Creechy. Come on, Creature. Come on, get out of there. I don't know why he's taking so long.
Kitty cat!
Well, so much for this being a short vlog. It's a first for me. I never got them in the crib together this long.
Get him, Creechy! Get that baby! Get the baby Brody!
There you go! You tried to tackle him and he dipped you out, boy. He dipped you out. He said, I'm out. Come here, buddy.
He's a good boy. He's such a good boy. Why'd you stay in there so long? You could have ran away. Boo-boo got out right away. You smell his butt, Boo-boo.
So that was fun vlog so far. That was pretty cool. All right, Daddy's got to go unclog those gutters though now. Well, so much for that being a short vlog today. Look, see, still coughing. Doctor says you're going to get rid of that on your own. I don't see it happening. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was pretty funny.
That was a good job, but you gotta be gentle with Creechy. You know, he might bite you, buddy. He might go, um.
But I mean, other cats get pretty rough with him, too.
Somebody is in a really good mood now after having those kitties in there, aren't you? Well, you were a second ago. Now you're not.
Hey! My man, I was talking to you. You were just screaming and stuff, and now you're all like, ugh.
That hair blowing. Alright, I think Daddy's gonna wait until it gets dark out to do these, because there are bees everywhere out here and they see me doing movement, they're like, hell no, dog. So they're pissed. So I'm gonna wait till it gets dark out. Damn, they're everywhere. Look, there's Brody up there. Hi, Brody. How you doing, buddy? Look at all the bees out there. It's no good. Daddy's gonna go out back first. I'll bring you out back with me, okay? We'll do this later. Gotta wait till it gets dark. Or at least, like, somewhat dark. Alright, this is where our pool's gonna go, over here. But first, I gotta clear out all this, and then I'm gonna put Brody in the other room until those bees go away, because that's gonna be a pain in the ass. So, yeah, pool's going over here. Might start the pool today, but I doubt it. This is going over here. I mean, from there to over here for now. We're out to the trash. Giving Brody a bottle of water for the first time ever. Because it's very warm today. It's nice and cool. He's like, what is this? I don't know if I like it. Ugh. Formula is too warm, buddy.
You'll get used to it. Everybody in the world drinks it. The whole time Daddy's been out here moving all that stuff around, he's been whining. More than half the time. He doesn't know what he wants.
Alright, so I got this area ready for the pool. Frank's watching Brody, as you can see. So, there's all the stuff. Well, 2 bags of leaves, might be some more. And all the wood that was over here. I believe this, from what I can tell by looking at it, I got a tape measure. It's at least like 20 feet almost. So the pool's 18 feet. I'm gonna go get the tarp and see if we can like fit it and see where it's exactly gonna fit. I mean, I don't wanna have to get rid of this thing, but if I do have to do that, I will. But I don't think that's really worth doing. All right, so there's the pool. I haven't put one of these together in over a decade. But I know it's like really basic and easy, but the only thing is that thing weighs a lot. It weighs over 200 pounds. So I'm just gonna like start opening it and going through things and organizing it in the garage here and start moving it out back. And hopefully we can get it all done tonight because we only got like 4 hours of sunlight left. That should be more than enough time to at least get it started, and we'll fill it overnight. All right, so there's all the shit that was inside the Summer Waves 18 foot pool. You got 5 boxes, the tarp, the cover, and it's this pool right here. You got the instructions, obviously. There's no DVD, but I can find it online. So it's basically a tutorial. I guess I can show you how to do it. It's pretty fucking easy. Step one was obviously to rake up all the leaves and make the surface as smooth as possible. Step two, lay down the pool tarp under the liner. So, you know, just extra support for being it smoothed off and everything. Next step, get the pool liner lined up to how you want it to be. Make sure you know where the filter is going to be. I want it like along the fence. Next up is where it gets to be a pain in the ass. This is really hard with one person. You're meant to have two to do this. Then you're going to take these little T-shaped things and put them all around the top of the pool. Slide these in as well. I'm sure you can figure that out. And then you're going to take these little guys and press them, you know, through both holes when they're lined up. I can't do it with the camera in my hand, but you get the idea once through there. And you're going to do that all the way around the pool first before you do anything else. All right, after you get those in place, except see the one I didn't get because I got to balance this. I'm going to start putting these poles in and try to balance it out. Usually you have 2 people doing this, so like this is a little difficult for me, but you get the idea. Then next you're putting these little guys in, putting those guys on the bottom, popping them in here, pretty basic. All right, there it is, except for that one spot again over there. But I think once I get in there and I push all the inside out and start putting a little water in there, it'll expand because it's like just off. I gotta like make sure it just fits in there perfectly, which it's actually doing a good job. Rebecca's gonna go get my sandals. I'm gonna go in here and start pushing all this out. Yay, I don't even know how I'm gonna get in there. I guess I'm gonna have to hop over. All right, Rebecca's here to kind of give me a hand now.
I did, how?
I gotta use this to get over because I'm not building the ladder yet. She did help me untwist that, which was nice. One and done.
Do it.
Harder than that.
Nah.
It's wet a little bit. Alright, so now I'm gonna push all the sides back. I'm gonna put a little bit of water in there. You can hit pause.
Okay.
Hit pause. It really is.
Look at the froggy go. Jump, froggy, jump.
Alright, go take care of him and then come back out because I need you.
Okay.
Alright, after you got obviously all the edges pushed out as far as you want. Don't mind the tarp. I mean, it's gonna be hard with one person to keep it even. I mean, I plan on just cutting it off all on the edge anyway. It's just there for extra support, you know, in case some weeds grow through. But you wanna put like a small amount of water on the bottom and then do what I did before, that frog thing, kind of just smooth everything out as much as possible, and then you should be good. Then I still gotta do the filter and the ladder, which I might do tonight. If not, I'll do that tomorrow. There you go, that's pretty much it. These pools are really easy to do. So you saw that one person did this. It took me probably like 2.5 hours. But you know, it's worth it. All right, while the pool fills, I'm gonna put Brody in here for a few minutes and let him crawl around. It'll be fun. Never mind, he pooped. Mommy has to change him first. Here comes the naked baby. Mommy's struggling because she had the bug too and she's having sciatica pains, man. Being pregnant sucks.
Hey buddy, what's going on, man?
You know this stuff. It is kind of chilly, but it'll be alright, it'll be good for him to cool off. It's been a hot day. Hey, Hey, look. It's cold, huh? Oh, you won't like being splashed? What if I did it again? He's like, I'm thinking about it. Ah. Look. Ooh.
You okay?
It's like, should I do it? It's okay. Yeah, it stinks that it cooled off now. Maybe he won't even get wet. You gonna come out here or what? Ta-da, little baby. Let's get a nice little thumbnail or a selfie. Look at that, naked baby in the pool. It's starting to come up on you, dude. Hey, it's coming up on you. Look at the waves, they're coming up on you, man. It's okay. I'm not getting his face, I'm just getting his feet. I think it's because the temperature difference.
It's okay.
It's the temperature difference, that's why. Earlier today, if we got this done earlier, it would have been better. It would have been cooled off. You want to get out? What do you want to do? Look. Look, Dada's feet, look. You know this stuff, it's the water. What do you take baths in? We have to take advantage of the bottom of the pool. I mean, Daddy can't. He's too old to do that. Even though he would love to right now.
You're okay. Splash! Splash, splash!
Splash, splash! Ah! Silly Rex with a little bit of hose water on his line there. Oh, you see that? Whoa! Look at the hose water. It's because it's cold. Whoa! Look. Ah. Woo. Woo. Oh. He's okay. It's not that cold. It's hot out here. It's like 85, 90 degrees out. Alright. Okay. You want to get out? Alright, fun time's over.
Alright, so that was a complete fail. He didn't like that very much. It's too cold now. But Mommy's gonna take him in. All right, I think I smoothed it out as best as I'm going to without leveling the ground perfectly. You know, I did it on my judgment. No sand or anything. But I knew it was gonna be off balance a little bit over here. That's why I tried to push it all the way back, but the tarp slid up and see, I had an extra bit of room and it would have been a little more level, but 2 inches off ain't that big of a deal. You're not gonna notice it in a 4-foot pool. So yeah, I'm gonna go work on this filter. Hopefully I'll finish it tonight. If not, I'll be doing that tomorrow when I wake up. Fuck unclogging these gutters. I'm too exhausted and I still got shit to do with the pool. And there's still bees up there, so they're gonna have to wait. Bees, bumblebees. They're not bumblebees, they're wood bees or whatever the fuck they are. I gotta take out the trash, diaper shit, all kinds of stuff. I'm gonna put the filter together first. It doesn't look that complicated. Alright, so there's the filter. It pretty much came already together. I mean, anyone with some common sense can like put this together. I mean, it's dark out now. I know I gotta put like a pin thing in here somewhere, and it's in the garage, so I'm gonna go try to finish that up now. You ready to go to bed?
I'm
gonna check the mother. You say dada? Dada.
Hairball, clean that up tomorrow. All right, bedtime, buddy. Daddy just remembered that he's got your crib all over the place, but we'll just leave it here for tonight. It looks cool over here. It's not near the window, so you're safe. Let's go, let's put you in here. Got all fresh sheets and all that stuff. Whoosh. He's sleepy. He's done. Look, you want this? Look. How about this? Alright, I gotta try to calm him down. All right, well, I just put him down. I might as well go change the most disgusting thing ever, because it's trash night. Brody's poopy and pee-pee diaper thing that I change usually every week, but it's been 2 weeks. Ooh, the smell! Preacher, it's fucking awful! All right, so I'm trying to put these little pins in the filter before it gets dark, and guess who has to take up more trash? You guessed it, me, yay! All right, I think all the trash is good for now. And now, excuse me, we saved the easiest for last, the pool ladder. So I hope. I mean, like I said, it's been almost a decade since I put one of these pools together in the ladder. If not, we got this ladder over here in my shitty-ass shoes that I fucking wore the fuck out of. Don't judge me. All right, 45 minutes later, I'm finally done the ladder. And as I finish it up, I realize I fucked up. I made one mistake at the very bottom. Look. See how these are facing like that way? And look at this one. So now every time somebody, we can either put this on the inside of the pool or the outside of the pool, it's going to hurt your foot. And in order for me to take that off, all this has to come back off. So, fuck that shit, bro. That's going to stay like that, at least for a while, until I get bored one night and decide to fix it. Alright, so I ended up trying, but it was only to take two screws off to at least try it. But these fucking things, once I stepped on it, they're really in there good, and I'm not going to be able to get down there. I mean, what's the big fucking deal? I mean, you know, you might hurt your feet a little bit and annoy you. I think I did this with my old pool, too, like 10 years ago. Oh, well. I can hear Rebecca now. What the fuck is wrong with the fucking ladder? Fuck, fuck. Finally, time for a beer. Hot devil's so good. Beer is always so much better when you're really hard, when you work for it, because most of the time I don't really do too much. Well, at least when I'm sweating and stuff, it makes the beer taste that much better. I'm sure some of you know what I'm talking about. But I think, yeah, I'm going to end this vlog today. I wanted to put up a vlog today and one the other day, but as you heard, I had a stomach bug from Rebecca bringing it from her work, which was fucking awful. I don't remember the last time I was ever that sick. But anyway, we won't talk about that. I think I talked about it earlier today. I'm so out of it. I have this dope pool light I'm going to put in the pool. It was originally for a 14-foot pool, but now you see Walmart messed it up. Gave us a bigger pool. I'm not going to complain because, you know, it was $100 more for the pool, so we'll see how it works. But this will be it for this vlog, unless I record some more tomorrow morning when I'm putting this up and maybe going to pool, but I doubt it. Tomorrow I have my cousin Johnny's reunion show tomorrow. It's for a benefit, the band Bright and Early. There's like three other bands. I'm going to head out to there. I think it's in Oakland, New Jersey. I'm not 100% sure, but that's my plan as of now, unless for some reason my stomach bug comes back, but I highly doubt that. I'm not going to miss this show. But again, like, favorite, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, guys, and much appreciated for watching. Simple day, made the best of it. Take care, love you. Alright, now did I say I was going to end the vlog? As you know, it's usually a lie. I usually end up continuing. You should all know me by now. As soon as I have a beer, it's like, I don't just have a beer to have a beer. I have a beer to enjoy myself, and I don't know when to stop. But I ended up tuning on to Nub TV, again, one of my favorite channels out there, and he did this through a pool. Now that's an older video of theirs from 2014, but these guys continually do this kind of crazy stuff, and they're not paying me anything to like talk about their channel or anything. It's just their channel's that good. And when you like enjoy a channel, you're gonna talk about it. You're gonna like the button. You're gonna hit the like button. You're gonna subscribe. You're gonna favorite those videos. And I've been doing that all night. But I also have my pool out back. But again, Nub TV. Make sure you subscribe to them. You guys are missing out. I'm on their favorite playlist. That was like the third video on their. Out of 27 they have on there, I'm up to like 13 or 14, but if I watch the whole thing, I'm going to be up all night. I might go back and watch the rest of it, but I want to go out in my pool. There's no way, like I said earlier, I was like, oh, if I was a kid, I would be like swimming all around the pool at the bottom. I wanted to do that, but I had to finish this ladder and do this other shit, but it's a good thing I have this tripod and this bright light, because I have no lights out back. I'm going to go jump in the pool. It's not going to be like me riding in a pool like that in a car. But hey, bucket list, man. Or at least be there for one of their stunts like this. I would love to be there for that. And these guys are right in Ocean City. I mean, they're like right near me. I mean, I've tuned into them for multiple years. We've been on like similar TV shows throughout the years. So let's go out in the pool. Let's go see how it's doing. I got to check on it anyway, because if it overflows overnight, that's a big no-no. So if it's like halfway, I might have to stop it and then continue the next day. But let's go out in the pool. All right, before I go out there, I'm going to show you just how bright this light gets. Because it's ridiculously bright. It might be like too bright. Oh, look at that. Whited me out. Like, whoa. But I also have my kid's baby bib. It's a tiger. It's probably the only one that fits my neck. Actually, it doesn't fit my neck, and this is the biggest one.
Yeah. If you haven't noticed, I have a big head and a big neck, just like my son.
I was trying to do this and chug my whiskey and not make a big mess on my fucking self, but let's try it. This is our backyard. As you can see, it's pitch dark. All right, so it looks like it's doing good. It's only like 6 inches done, so we got a long ways to go. So it should be all right throughout the night. But let's jump in it. All right, we need to test out the ladder before anybody else uses it. So I might not be able to use that tomorrow going to Johnny's show. So we're gonna do this first and see how it works. It's not as warm as it was earlier. It's only like 75 now, but it's still really cold. It's fresh water. See you later, Charbot. I'll get you tomorrow. All right, well, that was fun. I'm all covered up now. I have my son's bib, you know, and I got one of these things going to cover up my bosoms. I think that was a more appropriate way to end the vlog. But am I going to end it or not? I'm going to eat this nasty apple. It's not nasty. I just started eating it. Look, it's already turning brown. Apples turn brown so quick. She's white under there. Again, like, favorite, subscribe. And again, thank you, Frank. I'm sorry I didn't say that earlier, for watching Brody for a good hour. He took him for a walk. Because I needed that extra time. And I'm going to shoot this in the trash can. Oh, wait, all the trash is out front that I brought out there. Oh, I can't wait till Rebecca's not pregnant anymore so she can actually help. I like you. All right. right, so I ended up staying up and watching all of NubTV's favorite playlist there of their video content. And that was awesome, by the way, guys. Thank you for putting that favorite playlist together. My favorite playlist sucks, because I always hit favorite to try to get more people to watch. And man, I'm glad to see another YouTube channel out there. Not saying another, because I don't do that shit anymore. I'm too old. I got kids. I can't be doing dumb shit. And they're on a whole other level. I never did stunts like that. It was like us drinking at parties and wake-up pranks and fucking, you know. Some of the dumbest things I did was a light tube between my legs, ride bikes off the roofs. I don't know, stupid shit like that. But they put it on a whole level. You really got to get on that TV. But they reminded me of like some of my older DVDs. I traded in most of my DVD collection because, honestly, there's no use for DVDs today. And I did back up all my DVDs as a digital file. And the place I traded them in at, they wouldn't take any of these DVDs. I bet they would wish they did now. I mean, that was like 5 years ago. But this is one of my old school ones, like the Whiskey DVD, volume 1 and 2 on one disc. I don't know if they know about it. I mean, today's content puts us to shame, but this was like one of the originals. I mean, this was like fucking old as balls. It's like 90s VHS shit, you know, with the big ass cameras. Got the Steve-O DVD, of course. I had 1, 2, and 3. I think some of my friends borrowed Never Give Back. Of course, Bum Fights. I mean, if you don't know about Bum Fights, then, you know, it was a little offensive. I mean, they got arrested all shit. But Crazy White Boys. FUTV Volume 1. Now, this is a must look at. You ain't going to find it online anywhere. I hope you can. Pritchard vs. Dayton. Those European crazy motherfuckers. This thing is awesome. There's just one scene that stands out in my mind where the guy poops in his hand and hits himself in the face with a pie face. Of course, a Jackass movie. But before that, I had all the CKY videos too. But the place that actually took in the DVDs actually accepted all my CKY DVDs because they're pop. They're mainstream when Jackass came out. I mean, I might have so much other video content here. I mean, my DVD, Ignorant Fuckface, I never actually made it mainstream. But one day it will, and then I got my S9 DVD. Well, it was VHS. I transferred to DVD. They make me want to influence myself to put that on there. I know they had VHS content, too. I'm not sure if it's on their channel. I haven't gotten through all their stuff lately. You know, being a father, I don't get to keep up with their stuff. But I think I'm going to try to put my Asinine video up. It's 2 hours long. You'll see I used the VHS player and a Hi-8 tape and just kept it in pause and record. And I had no computer, but that's how I bought my first computer and started editing. Made Ignorant Fuckface. But these guys are legit. NubTV, man. Seriously, like, get on them and check them out. Man, I just want to sit here and watch like crazy content all night. Because YouTube today, they're like frowned upon. My content is frowned upon. I mean, a lot of my shit gets flagged. I have a lot of fucked up shit I want to share. I put a lot of them on my Facebook and that gets flagged too. So I'm sure it'll be flagged on YouTube too. But as of now, I think you can flag it as adult content yourself. And it won't get flagged. I'm not sure. But I never got around to putting up videos. I only put 2 videos up Monday and Tuesday this week. I wanted to put up a throwback of like my childhood and 2 other vlogs, but it's not a big deal. I can always catch up because I don't make 7 vlogs a week. You know, I don't do that. So I usually make like 3 or 4. So next week I'll be all caught up. Hopefully when I wake up tomorrow I put up at least 2 or 3. Goddamn gnats. Damn it. But anyway, what I was trying to say is, also, by the way, CZW Tournament of Death. By the way, I'm going to 2 wrestling shows, like Tournament of Deaths. CZW was started by Zandig, and he has a Tournament of Death coming up. It's called Tournament of Survival. It's called, I think it's Game Changing Wrestling. I'm not sure. But I'm going to that next weekend. It's on a Sunday. And then the following week is Tournament of Death. My favorite time of year. I love underground backyard wrestling. It is my shit. It's not even backyard wrestling. These guys are so talented. And I just watched the WWE pay-per-view that day, and it was like, I forget, it's Extreme Rules. Oh, God, it was fucking awful. I mean, there was a couple bumps. I liked watching, what's his name, Jericho take the thumbtack bumps from Dean Ambrose, which was Jon Moxley, in CZW. And he took some amazing bumps. And I get it. It's like for kids today. But kids shouldn't be watching somebody do thumbtacks like that. The parents are probably like, no, you can't watch this. Guys, just give up on the whole, like, kid shit. Because most of the people that watch wrestling today
are adults and they want to watch that. And I'm still waiting for a company to like push it on Showtime or HBO. It's bound to happen. I mean, more internet pushes like up through entertainment levels. There's going to be a company that's going to blow WWE out the water, just like ECW did a long time ago, and it's bound to happen. Mark those fucking words. Like, whether it's CZW, Game Changing Wrestling, IWA, any like crazy hardcore company, like adults don't want to watch two men tackle each other and slam each other on basically a mattress. They want to see blood. They want to see violence. Like, the storylines are cool too, but we want to see awesome-ass, like, violent matches, man. That's one other thing I want to say. Hopefully this will be the end of the vlog, but you never know me. I just keep going and I keep going and I keep ranting. But, man, Nub TV again. Awesome. Awesome. Can't believe I finished all 27 of them. They got shorter through the times. I guess whoever edits them. There's three brothers, I believe. I'm not always 100% sure, so no disrespect. I mean, but I my mind's fried. So, but seriously, check them out. It's fucking awesome. And I don't know. Again, like, favorite, subscribe, and all that other crap. And tomorrow, you may see me go in the pool with this light on after my cousin's show. The pool. Get out of the pool. I'm actually not cold. It's very nice out tonight. Summer is fucking here, man. Memorial Day fucking weekend, dude. Yes. Get fucked up. Dad life. Seriously, though, dad life. I gotta wake up and change diapers and like fucking... It's like 2 now. It used to be a normal time I'd go out till when I did go out on Thursdays, which, you know, you see me still go out with my friends sometimes. But I can't continue to do that always, especially when... Beckham comes here. Baby number 2. Baby boy number 2. That's it, man. I ain't going to be able to go do that all the time. Hopefully I can. Hopefully he sleeps just like Brody does. We'll see, though. Time will tell. Like, favorite, subscribe. Again, end.